The message has long been hammered home.
If you have symptoms, if in doubt, get a test, because that is the most important thing that you can do to help control this virus across the country.
But right now, it's not that easy. Take Steve Hind, whose young children developed a cough.
We booked online and the nearest test centre they offered was Telford, which is over 2 hours drive away. Then when we arrived 5 minutes before our appointment, we were met with a scene of confusion, people being turned away. So we weren't able to get our children tested. We were told they'd run out of tests.
Steve's tweet about his experience prompted others to share similar stories. Some posted screenshots showing how far they would have to travel for tests. One called the situation an utter shambles. The Labour leader challenged Boris Johnson at PMQs.
But this is basic stuff. People who've got COVID symptoms are very anxious about themselves, their children, their families, and what to do. It means they can't go to work, they can't send their children to school. It matters. And if they can't get tests, the Prime Minister needs to take responsibility.
NHS Test and Trace is doing a heroic job, and today I can tell him that most people get an in-person test result within 24 hours, and the median journey is actually under 10 miles.
Yesterday, the head of the NHS Test and Trace Service in England blamed a lack of lab capacity for the problems. Today, Boris Johnson and Matt Hancock said healthy people going for tests were clogging up the system. Whatever the reason, there are testing centres like these lying virtually empty, while local people are told there's no availability.
But it's a complex situation.
You can have a cough for a few hours and suddenly think you're a bit worried. And maybe by the time you actually go for the test, the cough's gone away and you're fine. And maybe it was just a bit of hay fever or something. It's really, really hard. So I don't think it's fair to say that too many people are being tested. But also, I think it's fair to be patient with the testing service because it is under tremendous strain.
The government is pledging to double the number of tests to 500,000 a day within 2 months. With the infection rate rising, the pressure is on. Tessa Chapman, 5 News.